Welcome students, Namaskar. In the previous session, we discussed about double-sided errors and now we will be discussing about single-sided errors, which will not allow the trial to tally. Errors which affect one account can be rectified in two ways. First, by giving an explanatory note in the account, and second, by recording journal entry through suspense account. Now, what is this suspense account? When the trial balance does not tally, then temporarily this difference is transferred to an account which is called suspense account. Example of these kind of errors are, first, error of costing, that is totaling; errors in carry forward; next, errors in balancing; next, posting to a correct account but with wrong amount; next, correct account, wrong side; next, wrong side, wrong amount; and next, forgetting to post an account. All these errors will not allow the trial to tally. All similar nature. Now, if the errors are discovered before posting to the ledgers, it can be corrected by crossing it, writing the correct amount and initialing it by the accountant. But this is not a common method, because I think you know your books will look like something very bad. Moreover, never erase and write, and never overwrite, as this will reduce the authenticity of the accounts, as if something is concealed. A better and smart way will be, either note the correction on the appropriate side for neutralizing the effect of error, or you can make a journal entry through the use of suspense account. Now, let us see how both these methods work one by one. Starting with the first one, that is, noting the correction on the relevant side means, say for example, if RAM account is debited short by 500, then we can debit RAM account with 500 more and the error will get rectified. Take another example. If Shyam account is credited more by 700, then what you will do? We will debit Shyam account so that the credit effect is reduced. Now, this will be done by writing in the debit difference in the amount posted and the figure, whatever is the difference. Now, coming to the second way, that is journal entry through suspense account. When the trial does not tally and the accountant cannot wait, he has to go through with the process of accounting. So, what he do is, he puts the difference in a suspense account, that is on the shorter side, just to tally the trial. The next point is to look for the errors now, and as soon as the errors are located, maybe any account or any amount, that particular error is rectified, an amount is transferred from suspense account, and in the end, if all the errors are rectified, suspense account will become nil. Now, let us understand this process in a step by step manner. First, identify the account in which it is affected because of error. Second, see whether it is excess or short, debit or credit, whatever it is. If it is excess debit or short credit, then you credit that account, because excess debit will be tallied with credit and short credit will also be tallied with credit, and the remaining suspense account will be debited. In the reverse case, if there is excess credit or short debit, then in that case we will debit that account and suspense account will be created. Let us discuss few entries in detail to understand this process practically. We are taking the first example, simple one, sales book undercast by 5000. Now, sales book balance is credit and it is less, which means trial is short credit. So, suspense account will be in credit because it is there where it is short. Now, when we will rectify, we will debit the suspense account because now the suspense is clear, ki it is sales. So, suspense was credit, now it will be debited. And what will be credited? Yes, sales account will be credited. Coming to next point, sales to Ramesh 4000 not posted to his account. Now, please remember, not posted, it means the entry is recorded in the sales book, but not posted in the account of Ramesh, which means we have not debited Ramesh account, but recorded in the sales book, that is credit part is fine. So, trial will show less debit. So, suspense will be in debit. Now, when we rectify, suspense will be credit and Ramesh will be debit. So, you understand, if the suspense is in debit, you have to credit it when you find the error. If the suspense is in credit and you find the error, it is debit. So, we have to analyze entry wise. Come to the next one. Purchase from Monu 50,000, posted as 5,000 in Monu account. Now, what is the right entry? Debit purchase 50,000, credit Monu 50,000. But by mistake, we have credited Monu as 5,000. Purchase is okay. So, Monu account is less credit 45,000. It means trial will be less in credit. So, where there is less, there is suspense. That is, suspense 45,000 is in credit in trial balance. And when we will rectify, we will debit suspense 45,000. And what will be credited? Yes, Monu 45,000. Because now the suspense is clear that it was due to the error in the account of Monu. Next point. Sales to Sonu 35,000 credited to his account, it would have been debited, right? So, the right entry is debit Sonu 35,000, credit sale 35,000. But what we have done is we have credited both sales and Sonu both, because he said it was credited to his account. So, sale part is okay, it is credited. And Sonu instead of debit is credited. Now, it makes the credit more in trial balance. By how much? 70,000, because both are credit 35, 35, 70. So, where is less in debit? So, suspense will be in debit. Suspense debit 70,000 in the trial. Now, what we will do in rectification entry? Now, we will credit suspense 70,000 to negate that debit in trial, and we will debit Sonu by 70,000, 35,000 to negate the credit and 35,000 to bring the correct effect in the required entry, right? Let us come to the last topic of this chapter, that is rectification in next trading period. When some errors are not rectified in a particular period and are carried forward to the next accounting period and they have to be rectified, then we have to remember one very important point, that is all nominal accounts of income and expenses shall be now called as profit and loss adjustment account. Why? Now, this is done in order to avoid the impact on the next year accounting statements, because you know revenue account is prepared for the year, and if these mistakes are of previous years, it should not affect the accounts of the current year. Let us take an example. Salary paid 500, wrongly debited to RAM account, and if it is to be rectified in the next accounting period, then first of all, the usual entry in rectification is debit salary and credit RAM, but because we are rectifying in the next period, what we will do is instead of salary, we will write P&L adjustment debit and credit RAM. So, what is the difference is instead of salary, we had put P&L adjustment, so that we are able to explain that this is an adjustment of profit and loss belonging to the previous year and not to the current year. Now, this particular topic is in 11th class just for a simple knowledge, and its detail is going to be studied at advanced level of study. Now, let us see some rules or conclusions as discussed in the last class. There were few rules which we have not discussed. Point number one, if a transaction is recorded in journal proper and it is written not posted, that means both the aspects debit and credit are missing. This is very important because in journal proper we record those entries which are not specifically there in the books, like purchase book, sale book, purchase return, sale return, they are not there. So, we record only those entries which have two aspects in journal proper. So, it means both the aspects are missing. Second, but if the transaction is recorded in cash book or subsidiary book and it is written not posted, now here it means it is not posted to one account. That is, it is a single sided error. In other words, cash book or subsidiary book is okay, but if the transaction is recorded in cash book or subsidiary book and then it is written not posted, it means it is not posted to one account. That is, it is a single sided error, trial balance not tallied. In other words, we can say cash book or subsidiary book is okay. So, my dear students, this brings us to the end of this very, very interesting chapter and a basic one. Here you have understood how many types of error are there: omission, commission, compensating and principal, how we commit them while recording the transactions, and then we have learned how to rectify them: single sided error which affect the trial, double sided error which do not affect the trial, and so on. In our next session, we are going to start chapter 7, depreciation, provisions and reserves. Till then, go through this very important topic and learn these things. Happy learning. Namaskar.